Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the climb on the Premier League U16 Sports Schools Cup.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Manchester Regional Arena for the Under-16 Small Schools Cup Final, sponsored by the Premier League. It's Gordon School versus Church Stretton School. And we've just had an absolutely cracking match in the Schools Cup Final. I'm very much hoping that this one will be just as good. We've already had a little bit of drama here today. Gordon School, there was a little bit of a mistake with shirts, nothing to do with Gordon School, I should add, and it's ended up that they've had to wear some reserve shirts, and the numbers are a little bit mixed up, as you can say. It's Andrew Sadler, James Archer, Max Bacon, George Taylor, Ben Murphy, Dan Lowe, Charlie Marshall, Alfie Kitchen, Oakley Bucock, Will McKechnie, and Matt Cockerham. Gareth Hall is the manager. This is the Church Stretton School. Natty Marston in goal, Ellis Brain, Josh Murphy, Matt Cole, Thomas Perkins, Jack Leask, the captain, Archie Austin is number 7, Matt Ashley, James Hill, Owen Holdsworth, and number 14 coming into the squad, he wasn't initially in the starting 11, is Mike Snedden. Thomas Ward is the manager. As for the substitutes, well, we have some repeat numbers on the green team. So Cameron Wallace, Joe Reed, Barney Fisher, who doesn't have a shirt at the moment, and Adam Kruger are wearing numbers of players who are already on the pitch as well. So that's going to make it difficult. And I've just noticed the numbers. Lovely to see a black on green. I may be struggling to name some of these players. Church Stretton, who are in the white, with very lovely dark numbers on their white shirts. It's Aidan Sperling, Lewis Parks, Umar Ahmed, Josh Chard, and Luke Leonard. Our referees, we have Ollie Langford as our referee, Paul Wilcox and Ian McGuinness, assistant referees, and Les Lever is our fourth official. Pretty good atmosphere here today. It was an absolute cracking atmosphere. There was probably over 1,000 kids packed into this stand on the near side. And there was well over 1,000 watching those penalties. There's numbers watching on YouTube, absolutely incredible here. As people are obviously getting used to watching these ESFA finals. Every single one covered live and free on YouTube. So the toss of the coin. All the honours are done. We're ready to get underway. Two halves of 40 minutes. As you saw there, it's a little bit windy. The wind is sort of more coming towards the camera a little bit more now. And it's certainly a very chilly day, but if you're playing football, you're not going to feel that at all. So off we go. The Under-16 Small Schools Cup Final. And this is a promising early start. Oh, there's a foot on the ball, a goal. What a start here. Amazing. There's less than a minute on the clock. Owen Holtz with a scored. Here you see, as the wind gets up even more. We'll just look at this goal again. Beautiful pass in from James Hill. And there's the ball in over the top. And Holdsworth gets a foot. And what a start this is. We're 30 seconds on the clock. And we haven't even brought up the scoreboard yet. There you go. It's 1-0 to Church Stretton. What a start for this school. Owen Holdsworth scored a hat-trick in the semi-final at De La Salle Academy in Liverpool. Scored 9 goals in 6 games. We'll make that 10 in 7. Church Stretton's absolutely on fire at the moment. That was Josh Murphy getting in on the action. Here's Holdsworth again. Swings the ball in. Well cleared. Murphy. Gordon's trying to build some sort of move. They've not really had much of a ball already. That's about as good a start you can get. The first attack of the match, seconds on the clock. Well, let's have another look at that goal here. Swung in by the number 7, Archie Austin. And here comes Holdsworth with a touch on the ball, putting it into the goal. Holdsworth with a flick on. At the moment it's all Church Stretton. That ball from Gordon's just running through. But there is a fairly strong right to left also just blowing in. It's coming towards the camera and a little bit right to left, so you will find that the ball does run through on the left-hand side, and sometimes the goalkeepers on the left are having a tough time reaching the halfway line. There's a few hundred teams entered this small schools cup competition. Thank you. this small school's cup, as the sun really blasts in on us here, is all for schools with 64 or less pupils. Here's a chance to Gordon. What a beautiful turn that is. Great save. Ball still free. Keeper's got to come out again, and it's gone wide. Absolutely wonderful play here. There's the save from the keeper. Absolutely wonderful. That's kept Gordon's in it. That's kept Church Stretton into the lead. So 64 less pupils in a school. So you really are looking at not a wide choice of footballers. And I remember watching the school's cup final, the small schools last year. Incredible to see the talent that was on offer. Gordon's play a long, big ball in, and the header is well handled by the goalkeeper, Natty Marston. Holdsworth again, looks very dangerous indeed. But frustration gets to him badly there as that one hits the turf. Just looking at the past matches that these teams have had to play. Gordon School. They, in their first match, they was 0-0 at full time, and they won 6-5 on penalties. Away at Richmond Park Academy. In round two, they travelled again to the Brit School for Performing Arts and Technology, based in Croydon, and won 5-0 away. In round three, it was another away trip to the Priory School from Orpington of Bromley, and that was a 4-3 extra time win. In round four, away to Debenham High School from Lowestoft. A fair little trip that was, and a 4-2 victory there. In round five, it was a trip to Buxwood School from South East Sussex, and that was a 7-2 victory. And finally, in the semi-final, a 2-1 home victory, at last a home match, against Holdsworthy Community College from North Devon. That was a fair trip for the Devonians, if that's the correct word. As for Church Stretton, their first round, it was a 6-0 away victory against Sundown School and Sports College from Shrewsbury. In round two, a 3-0 away victory against Lakelands Academy from North Shropshire. In round three, it was a 2-0 victory over Ulster Grammar School from Midlands and South Warwickshire. In round four, a 5-2 home victory against Anthony Gell School from the Amber Valley region. In round five, a big 5-0 victory over King Edward VI Grammar School, a coastal and Wolds area. And finally, a tremendous result here, a 4-0 victory against De La Salle Academy from Liverpool, who are certainly no pushovers. There's a long ball in. Keeper handles that very well. So, very noticeable, Church Stretton have had 5 clean sheets in their 6 matches. Holdsworth with a ball. So they do have a very strong defence to Church Stretton. And you can already see that the goalkeeper is a very solid keeper indeed. He's been put under a little bit of pressure early on. He's had a few longer balls coming in and has handled them easily.
This one's coming in, Murphy.
10 minutes gone. It's Will McKenzie, number 18, playing up front. And Here's an opportunity. McKenzie's hunting this one down, but that ball is too tight to the keeper, and Natty Marston handles it easily. Ellis Brain shows he's got two good feet. Matt Ashley, nice play from Ashley, gets past his man, tries to play in Josh Murphy, number three, who's playing as right midfield. Murphy's only got one to beat, and straight into number 11, Max Beacon, or Max Beacon, I should say. Ball across, puts his own team into a little bit of trouble there. That was Archer, number 10, getting involved. And here's Holdsworth. He's managed to find himself a bit of space. He's got one man to beat and has beaten him. Goes for the shot with a power, and the keeper can only parry that one. And the crowd here appreciating that. Certainly looks a very dangerous player, Owen Holdsworth. Long throw from Mike Stedham, no flick on. Gordons are very happy to just play the big balls at times. Church Stretton quite comfortable with that. Wind holding that ball up, look at how it swerves in the air. It's like playing against extra man at times. Ellis Brain down the line. Archie Austin, Church Stretton wins the throw. Substitution very early on. Number 17 is off. Number 12 is on. Dan Lowe, the captain. I wonder if he's got a bit of an injury. Adam Kruger is coming on, so we've now got two number 12s, unfortunately. If it wasn't a tough enough job today to read those black numbers on the dark shirts. The bad news for Gordons is that their captain looks as if his day might be over. Holdsworth again with the snapshot. This time, keeper is comfortably holding it. With the kick directly into the wind. Here's Ashley. Out to Murphy. Back to Snedden. Snedden looks to play in Holdsworth. Holdsworth flicks onto Murphy, who's overlapped. Good play from Church Stretton. They're finding spaces down this right-hand side. Snedden with a long flow, flicked on. James Hill looking for the long throw again, but it was just a little bit too long. An offside given against Holdsworth. Long kick downfield from George Taylor. And that's a dangerous ball in. And that was a better chance, I think, than what he realised there. Good kick from the goalkeeper, managing to find the Gordon's half. Holdsworth. Nice ball down the line. Josh Murphy's chasing this. Covered by George Taylor. And goal kick. There's another substitution out there. So Matt Ashley. Joe Reed is coming on, number 8, and Matt Cockerham is off. Now, that looks like it could be a straight swap at left back, and it might be due to the fact that Church Stretton are getting a lot of interest down that line. Referee's not interested there, that was accidental. Strong enough, it's Holdsworth is offside. Not very good conditions for our cameraman here, or cameramen. We have an incredibly cold, biting wind into us, and now the sun is going down over in that area, so it's really, really tough for these guys to do their jobs. They're doing it well. Coming up to halfway through this first half. Church Stretton with a goal lead within the first 30 seconds. Oh, that's a good play. Oh, it's an equaliser. Gordon score, and we are level. Here's the replay. Lovely pass through, and for only the second time in this tournament, Church Stretton have conceded a goal. I don't think anybody actually knows who scored here because of the numbers on the back of the shirts being so difficult to read. Even the announcer in the stadium hasn't made a call yet. I don't blame him. I do apologise for all you Gordon School fans out there and for those players watching this later on, but we do have the sun directly into our eyes, and those shirt numbers are very difficult to read indeed. It's a dangerous cross towards the back post. And did that hit the base of the post as well? Well, let's look at this goal again. Wonderful play, and that's a great finish. Perkins with a header away. Perkins again. Inside to Austin. Cleared by Bray. The referee blowing his whistle. He's not happy with something. I think it was a challenge. And he's given a free kick and having a little stern talking to with one of the Church Stretton players. These balls are certainly having a lot of extra weight on them with this wind from behind. Long distance shot blocked by Matt Ashley. And here comes James Hill, who's fresh from his grilling from the referee a few seconds ago. In fact, a throw was given. See a couple of the Church Stretton players just querying that with the linesman, but the linesman saying that the ball had just
gone. Number 17, Dan Lowe.
Dan Lowe, number 17. Well, that means he must have come back on. Well, there you go. I'd written him off 5 minutes ago. He sneaked back onto the pitch and scored a goal. Well, well done to our announcer for going to find that information out. Solid challenge from Jack Leese, the captain. Well, that one was too long from Lowe. Gordon's getting more into this game. Certainly the wind behind is helping. And Church Stretton finding it difficult to get the ball up to their front line, who are looking like a very dangerous front line, to be honest. They've got Hill, Holdsworth and Murphy, 9, 10 and 3 in a row. It really is quite a traditional sort of 4-3-3 in a way that Church Stretton are playing. Murphy challenging Beckham. Gordon's get possession back. Lovely through ball, that's a nice one too. Gordon's looking for a shot from the edge. Deflection. Defender makes a great call there to clear that ball away. There, nearly letting in Hill. But there is cover. Gordon's keep possession. That's a lovely ball trying to free Beckham down the left. Just a little bit too much on it. Holdsworth, little flick on, he's got one more man to play, and if he can, here's Hill. Hill's going to shoot and scores. James Hill puts Church Stretton back into the lead. And all from the throw-in. We'll take another look at it in a second. Great play. Here we go again. Here's the finish. Beautifully put away, in off the post. Church Stretton lead 2-1. Result from the throw-in. Corner kick here for Gordons. We'll have another look at that in a second. Still plenty of time. 14 minutes left in this first half. Gordons swinging the corner in. Lots of pressure. The keeper almost misjudged it. Managed to get a hand up at the last second. And now Church Stretton on the counter. Here's Hill. Here's Murphy. There's plenty of players up. It's 5-2. That's incredible numbers. And now there's a chance for Gordon's on the counter. Church Stretton had so many players up front for that attack. It truly was five white players, attacking players, against two defenders. Beckoned as well to clear that. He was under pretty heavy pressure there. Well, let's have a look at this goal again. It all came from the throw-in. And there was the throw. Holdsworth turned his man, then got a little toe poke in, and this was the ball from Holdsworth. Beautiful ball to Hill. And Hill, great touch, one touch, and then side pass, side footing it into the corner of the goal. Stretton clear the lines and Holdsworth is onside. If he could just keep the ball in. That was well played from Owen Holdsworth. Like a good old up and under sometimes, just to break up the play a little bit. Nicely played from Matt Cole there at the back. And Holdsworth looking to get on the end of this again. Slight fumble from the keeper. Well, he's got the benefit of kicking with the wind in this half, but in 10 minutes time, he'll be having trouble the other way. Cross in, but Church Stretton, a very solid defensive unit, as we've seen. That's a wonderful ball inside to Hill, back to Holdsworth. Church Stretton have got two players in the centre, and here's a man overlapping on the left hand side as well. Plays it straight in. Hill shoots. Oh, that's so close. Great, great play here. And when Church Stretton attack, they really do attack with venom, don't they? Here's the move again. Holdsworth, he's got two in the box at this stage. And it just doesn't fall nicely for Church Stretton, but the man on the overlap plays it back to Hill, and Hill has only just scored. Francis again, and that is so close. Took a shade of paint off the goalpost. half an hour gone.
Gordon School
leading, sorry, one, Church Stretton School two. Again, a little bit too much on that ball. And straight through to the keeper. Challenge from Archie Austin. Throw to Gordon's. We have two more matches here tomorrow. We have the Under 16 Schools Cup for girls between Frome College and Thomas Telford School. And then it's the Under 16 Open Schools Cup between Ravenswood School and Reddish Vale High School. Well played there from low. Church Stretton have to clear their lines, and they've done it quickly. Holdsworth again hunting that ball. Then the referee gives the free kick to Church Stretton. Yes, Mr. James Hill hasn't really come here to make friends. Holdsworth with the kick. Now, we've already seen that he's quite happy to have a shot from this sort of range, so he could be tempted. There's only one in the wall. There are six Church Stretton players lined up for the cross. Here it comes. Knocked back in. And good save. A good save from Andrew Sadler in the Golden School goal. Good footwork. Didn't commit himself too early. Holdsworth again onside. Beckham's coming in for the challenge and will give the corner away. Or did his best to keep it in, of course. Holdsworth stays to take it. Six players from Church Stretton in the box again. In fact, there's only one player from Gordon's upfield, so he's been marked by three players at the moment. Ashley just runs into too much traffic there. To Gordon's. Wind causing a little bit of chaos again. Ellis Brain. Nice ball inside to Jack Lees, the captain. Plays a sloppy pass but gets away with it, and Hill looking to play in Holdsworth, who was onside. Beckham goes for the big long ball. Looks like Gordon's possibly have fallen into the trap of that we sometimes see playing with the wind behind, that very tempting to be hitting the big balls down the field, but all you end up is eating up the clock. Well, you have that little bit of an advantage of the wind behind you. I think Church Stretton, if you'd have said to the coach at half time, will you take a 2-1 lead kicking against the wind, I'm sure he would have been happy with that. Long throw, Holdsworth tries to back heel it for Murphy. Lovely switch of play, but cleared by Taylor. Austin, nice ball inside for Ashley. Back to Hill, back to Ashley again. Holdsworth, lovely little through ball to Murphy. Murphy releases the trigger, and Hill was almost in to finish that off on the back post as well. Good football from Church Stretton. James Murphy. Well, I mentioned Murphy, Hill and Holdsworth are certainly three very dangerous players. Two of them have got on the score sheet, and we nearly had the third. Down the line, it was Ben Murphy involved for Gordons. Throw to Gordons. Frustrated voices you can hear on the pitch there from some of the Gordon's players wanting a little bit more communication. Seconds to go here in this first period. First period? I've been covering ice hockey too much. First half of this under 16 Small Schools Cup for Boys, sponsored by the Premier League. As you see, the sun is getting quite low out there. Church Stretton School, white, kicking from left to right, leading by 2-1. As time is now up on our watch here. And in fact, time is up overall with our official. First half is over. Church Stretton lead by 2-1. Thank you. Well, let's have a look at the goals from that first half. Here we go, and this was the first goal, literally seconds on the clock. In fact, we'll get an official time on that in a short while. And there you see Holdsworth scoring. Just see this again here. This was Hill. Hill playing in the looping ball over the top, catching the defence unawares. Keeper was in no man's land. And Holdsworth, what a start that was. Well, that put Church Stretton 1-0 ahead, but this was a wonderful pass through. And this was 1-1 from Dan Lowe, the captain. This was the pass here. Beautiful pass from number 6, Alfie Kitchen, and Lowe plants it into the goal. The second time in 8 matches that Church Stretton have conceded a goal in this competition. But then Church Stretton went ahead. And a long throw. Holdsworth gets a little toe poke in here. And then this was the moment with the defender possibly committing himself towards Holdsworth. And James Hill side-footing the ball into the corner of the goal for Church Stretton to take the lead. And then we'll just put this in because this was in very close indeed. Wonderful play here again from Church Stretton. You just felt that they were almost going to score a third, and this was probably the closest they got, with James Hill, having just scored a few minutes ago, hitting a beautiful volley just shaved the post. So we'll be back very shortly for the second half. Church Stretton leading by 2-1. Thank you. So welcome back to the second half here. Gordon School have not only got a very good Church Stretton team to contend with in the second half, they've also got a very strong wind. I don't know if you saw that the wind just actually blew over the railings that the teams were walking in from. Which could have been quite nasty, could have taken out a whole team there. So off we go for the second half. Church Stretton kicking from right to left. Having got probably the difficult half out the way against this very strong wind. Look as if there's been any substitutions made at half time. By the looks of it. On, flicked on by Austin, and Holdsworth was sniffing on that back line yet again. Brain again, the left back. Long clearance with the right foot. Murphy hunting on the end of that. Here comes Holdsworth. Plays in Austin. Got too much weight on that pass. Hall with the big clearance from Church Stretton. Ashley. Gordon's trying break. This is good play from Gordon's. It's a long ball down the line, and Holdsworth again hunting on that back line, and offside given. Clear their line. There's McKechnie. Leask with a strong header for Church Stretton. Nice play there from James Archer for Gordon's, but just didn't pay off for him. Sadler has to clear. Oh, wind here getting stronger and stronger all the time. It's blowing half of my desk over at the moment. Having a real fight on just to keep hold of my team sheets. Sadler comes to clear up. Good old keeper sweeper option, doing its job again. Ketchney and Bucock up front for Gordons. Two of them working in tandem. There's a man down at the moment on the left-hand side. That's Josh Murphy. Looks like Church Stretton might well make a change. Here from Matt Cole. That's gone over everybody! And what a chance that was for Jack Lees, the captain. I think the Gordon's defence having trouble with the big long ball, and I would imagine that's certainly gone into the memory banks for the Church Stretton players. The substitution has been made. Josh Murphy is staying off and Aidan Spurling is coming on, the number 11. So Spurling is on. And he looks as if he's going to sort of a left midfield position, so maybe a like-for-like swap. We'll find out. Right in front of us, number 11, Aidan Spurling. Another man down as well up at the top for on the far side of the pitch for Church Stretton. Here's Archer for Gordons. Archer puts in a really good quality cross there, just managed to beat the first man. Archer wants the ball back. Good skills from Archer. Beat Spurling. Too much traffic around McKechnie there. Like Josh Murphy is running around again, so we may see a little bit more of him back on the pitch shortly. There you see at the top of the screen, the white, he's not actually part of the match. Normally they're asked to wear tracksuits, but the linesman is on that end of the pitch, so I don't think Murphy's going to upset anybody. Long ball forward there, the keeper's coming out into a very corner of the 18-yard box and handles that very well, does Natty Marston. Oh, the kick has gone through all the way and it's another goal for Church Stretton, the third goal for them and the second goal for Owen Holdsworth. And it really was good old-fashioned Route 1. Let's see that again. This is all the way from the back. The goalkeeper collects. And with the wind behind, gives it the good old fashioned big hoof. It completely misses out all of Gordon's defenders, and Holdsworth is in there and puts it away with his right foot. Very comfortable indeed. Gordon's really do have a job on now. Two goals down. Well, let's look at this again. All the way from the back. Goalkeeper kicks. And there's, within a second, it's Holdsworth putting it away. Minutes to go in this under 16 Small Schools Cup final. Dangerous chip in, but Natty Marston is not somebody who's used to letting many goals in, and he's gone for the big kick again. A little bit buoyed, I think, by that goal a little while ago. There's no doubt Church Stretton are sniffing more goals here. Maybe not from that distance. Number seven, Archie Austin. Holdsworth has two to his name. James Hill has one. If he's offside. Well, I did make a mention in commentary that maybe the Church Stretton players or the coach would have noted that a long ball seemed to give Gordon some real trouble at the back, and well, there it definitely paid off. Jack Leask clears, and Holdsworth is in, he's onside. Great goalkeeping from Andrew Sadler there. That was a very difficult one for him to handle. Another substitution. Now we go into the twilight zone here, because there is a number 12 coming off for Gordons. Whether it's Adam Kruger or Oakley Bucock, I've got a feeling it could be Kruger, but I'm not sure. And number 17 is coming on, which is the second number 17, Cameron Wallace. If it wasn't hard enough already for me to try and work out who's on the pitch, we've now got two number 12s and two number 17s. Looks like there could be a Church Stretton substitution as well. Not yet. So back with the action. Gordon's There's Charlie Marshall getting into the action. McKechnie, who's dropped back a little bit, playing more of midfield just recently. Low. Church Stretton with the confidence of a two-goal lead, as well as this wind, knowing that they can happily play a few balls down this pitch and buy themselves even more time. They do have time on their side. So that Church Stretton substitution is going to take place. Number 12 is Lewis Parks. Sorry, Mike Sneddon coming off, and Lewis Parks is coming on. You sense it. Gordon's really need to try and score very soon. Good skills from Holdsworth. He's got pace as well. That ball isn't cleared either. Here's Sperling. Sperling gives that ball away needlessly, and Gordon's have a chance to counter-attack. Here's Wallace. That's a good play from James Archer, but too many Church Stretton players. And Holdsworth again, finding himself in some space. He's totally on his own, though. He's getting some support eventually. And, well, he's getting it from James Hill, who managed to charge that ball down. Hill takes on his man, and the ground completely slides from under Hill's feet. Looks a little bit embarrassed there, but he played fantastically to get there. He was going to go all the way, wasn't he? He was really going to go for it. He did have support. That would have been a good chance for Church Stretton had Hill have kept his feet. Referee's blown for a little niggly foul from Holdsworth on Charlie Marshall. Ball from the back for Marshall. That's a lovely flick on Archer, and Gordon's have got men in the box here. Archer can get the ball in. This is good skill from Archer. Wonderful play from Archer. Gordon's got five in the box, and that one just didn't come off the foot properly. Took the big swing, and Marston wants to hit this one quickly. He's telling Holdsworth to get up there. Ball flies in the air. Holdsworth turns his man, and Holdsworth still goes. And that's going to be a corner kick. Well, that wind is as strong as ever here. Stretton swing it in. The ball's gone straight across the goal. Nobody could get a foot on it. Hill puts in a big swinger, but it's the wind just totally takes it. And over the bar. The sound of the railings going over again. I suggest they probably leave them where they are. Sadler really really tough wind he's kicking straight into here.
Gordon's,
oh, that lovely skill, but just one man too many. That was, I think that was Bucock there, up front, number 12. Here's Archer. Not the best throw in the world, and he's put his own man into trouble. Here's Austin now. Church Stretton on the counter. Holdsworth wanting the ball down the channel, plays it inside to Hill. Hill might go himself. He's hunting his second goal. Plays the ball forward, and the penalty is given. And it's Hill, who looks as if he might want to take this. Here we see this again. Hill goes away, he just gets a touch on it, and that's about as clear-cut a penalty as you could have. So it's going to be the number 6, Jack Leask, the captain. Who scores? And Church Stretton look to have sealed this Premier League Under 16 Small Schools Cup final. A fourth goal. Beautifully put away by Jack Leask. Under 20 minutes to go. Gordon's trying to make something of it, but they need to score 3 goals in what, 17 and a half minutes now. Surely that's going to be too much to ask. Long distance shot. Just look at this penalty again. Put away very well by Leask. Scuff goal kick from Marston there. At the back there for Gordon's. Church Stretton, quite a few players pushing up there. They've got 5 players forward in this move. There's a few players certainly sniffing another goal, and here's Leask again. That's a good attempt from distance, just over the bar. That's a lovely ball inside. Here's an opportunity. The goalkeeper stands up beautifully. Archie Austin there. Oh, penalty yet. Well, the offside flag was up anyway. There we go. After all that. And that's why the referee blew. There by the keeper to intercept that ball. I don't know what James Hill was doing back there, but he's come all the way back. Now he's back into his more accustomed position, puts some pressure on the kicker. Austin picks it up. Here's Hill again. Holds within the centre, hunting a hat-trick. Hill decides to just take a little bit of time here. Swings in a big cross towards the back post. Gordons do seem to have had trouble with the high ball. Another substitution is taking place over in the corner. Number 8 is coming off. Number 6. Well, that can't be right. That must be 16. Luke Leonard must have been a man coming on. And number 8, Matt Ashley coming off. Okay, well, it was Josh Chard, number 15, coming on. We had an 8 and a 6, which I think means Joe Reed for Gordons is on. And Alfie Kitchen has just left the field. Went to extra time and penalties. Very entertaining 1-1 game. You get the chance to see that. It is on the replay for YouTube. Here's Leask. Goes out wide to substitute Sperling, who's playing on the right side of field at the moment. He started off on the left, switched wings. Gordon's having real trouble getting into the Church Stretton half at the moment. Gordon sped the ball left. Lees clears up. And Gordon's could just do that sort of ball all day, to be honest, eating up the clock. 11 minutes to go. Plenty more action tomorrow. Schools Cup for girls and also the Open Schools Cup. That's a beautiful ball into Holdsworth, but the ball just, that wind just catches hold of it. Runs away. Number 7 comes off. Archie Austin. And number 11. That must be 17 actually, is Umar Ahmad. Oh, good play from Holdsworth here. He almost played in Ahmad. He could have played that one square and Ahmad could have had the most glorious first touch in the history of this competition. Only been on 5 or 6 seconds, he could have been putting the ball into the back of the net. But Holdsworth is on a hat-trick. And I think it's given him a leeway to have a go from there. Substitutions galore going on up on that bench. So number 3, Matt Cockerham is coming back on, and number 8, which is either Charlie Marshall or Joe Reed, probably Charlie Marshall to be honest, because I think Joe Reed only just came on, but Cockerham is back on the pitch. Bit of head tennis out there. Wild swing from Josh Chard. From some of the Gordon's players asking for a free kick there. It's a wonderful tackle. Well, that was a wonderful tackle. And this time the referee decides to maybe award the foul that he should have awarded maybe 20 seconds ago. James Hill there, pretty frustrated with himself. Chance to Gordon's, that's a wonderful ball in, well defended. Just Chard chasing down, kick downfield. Crowd are getting themselves into this a little bit. Just that's a solid challenge from Umar Ahmad, who possibly was more mistimed than malicious. Cameron Wallace with the kick. Ahmad, two number 17s. Leask plays a lovely ball over the top into the corner. Sperling battling away in the corner, wins the corner. Swung into the heart of the 6-yard box, there. And Gordon's counter well here. This is good play from Gordon's. Substitution, number 16, Luke Leonard comes on, and Owen Holdsworth will not have his hat-trick today, got two goals, and the first one after just, what was maybe 20 seconds or so. Done from Kruger, playing in McKechnie. McKechnie has put in a lot of work. More substitutions going on here. Mike Snedden is back on. And Thomas Perkins is off. Miscontrol there from Gordon's, and that will be a goal kick. From Marston. And certainly a lot of the gusto in this match is, well, there's a lot of gusto from the wind, maybe not so much from the players, because obviously this match is well and truly decided. Maybe a final chance here for Gordon's to get on the score sheet. Just coming up to a minute left. Not been a lot of injury time, it's fair to say. Three in the wall. And that was easily handled by Marston. Calling his players to get up, and then miskicks the ball. Parks with a throw. And the referee decides enough is enough. And Church Stretton have won this under 16 Small Schools Cup in some style.
by 4-1 here at the Manchester Regional Arena.
And the crowd are on the pitch yet again. It tends to happen at these school affairs. Final score here at the Manchester Regional. We're going to stay for the presentations. But as the crowd congratulates, as our MC tries his best to control what's going on. They don't seem to be too much of a rabble, do they? But the final score here, Gordon School 1, Church Stretton School 4. My name's Adrian Battersby. I hope you've enjoyed this coverage here by 24/7 TV for the England Schools FA. We are going to stay for the presentations. Two more matches tomorrow. We'll be back for those shortly.
Testing. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we'll now make the presentation of the medals and trophies on the field of play. Before we do that, I'd like to say some thank yous. First of all, to the Manchester Regional Arena for the hosting of this event. They've been fantastic hosts, and thank you to all the staff for all the hard work and preparations leading to today's event. We'd also like to thank Premier League for their generous sponsorship of this competition. Without their support financially, we'd be unable to run such a fantastic event. So once again, we are very grateful to the support that the Premier League have shown to schools football. Okay, let's show our appreciation for today's match officials. So as we call them forward, starting with the referee, Ollie Langford.
Ollie Langford.
The assistant referees, Paul Wilcox and Ian McGuinness. And the fourth official, Les Lieber.
Cheers, Cheers, Cop. Thanks, Cop.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Cheers, thank you.
Commiserations to Gordon School for today, but they really did put up a fantastic performance and they've done extremely well in reaching today's national final, which sees them as the second best team in the whole of England. So that in itself is a fantastic achievement. So let's put our hands together as we call the boys forward from Gordon School, starting with overall goalkeeper Andrew Sadler. Number two, George Taylor. Number three, Matt Cocker. Number six, Elfie Kitchen. Number eight, Charlie Marshall. Number 10, James Archer. Number 11, Max Beckham. Number 12, Oakley Bukar. Number 15, Ben Murphy. Number 17, the captain and goal scorer for Gordon School, Dan Lowe. Number 18, Will McKechnie. Substitutes from Gordon School today, Joe Reed. Adam Kruger, Cameron Wallace, and Barney Fisher. Okay, we'll just ask that the captain for Church Stretton School comes up last to collect the trophy. So if we start with the goalkeeper, let's show our appreciation for the national champions, Church Stretton School. Two, Alice Bray. Number three, Josh Murphy. Number four, Matt Cole. Number five, Thomas Perkins. Number six, the captain, Jack Leese. Number seven, Archie Austin. Number eight, Matt Ashley. Number nine, and goal scorer, James Hill. Number 10, and scorer of two goals, Owen Holdsworth. Number 14, Mike Sneddon. And substitutes for Church Stretton School this afternoon, number 11, Aidan Sterling. Number 12, Lewis Parks. Number 15, Josh Char. Number 16, Luke Leonard. And number 17, Umar Ahmed. So the captain of Church Stretton School, Jack Leese, will come forward to collect his medal. And also be presented with the trophy to crown Church Stretton School champions of the Premier League in the schools of the Under 16 Schools Cup for 2017. Let's have a huge cheer.
Well, I should also add, it was remiss of me not to do a man of the match there, but I will do it right now, better late than never. A number of players stood out. I think it was really James Hill was a close second. He was always very dangerous, but it had to be Owen Holdsworth, who was the man of the match as well.
Certainly from my point of view, there's a big difference between the two teams here today.
Extremely dangerous indeed. So Owen Holdsworth giving the player of the match as they go and get their All right, well, thank you very much for watching. We're going to head into the night. We'll see you again some other stage for sure. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.